Hello class 7th, I welcome you all in today's GK class. I hope you are all fit and fine at your respective homes. In today's class, we will be covering the chapter 20 to 23 and worksheet number 2. So now let's begin with our class. So, this is your chapter number 20 of your GK book, that is Grand Slam. Grand Slam, basically it means winning all the important matches or competitions in a particular sport. So here, Grand Slam tournaments are also called majors. There are four most significant tennis events determined by their ranking points and awarded prize money. Read about them and filling the blanks with the names of the correct tournament. So the first one is Wimbledon. This is one of the oldest and the most prestigious tennis event. Since its commencement, Wimbledon is held at All England Club, Wimbledon, London. It is held from late June to early July. The second we have is US Open. It is the second oldest tennis event. It was established in 1881. The US Open main tennis tournament involves singles for men and women, doubles for men and women, mixed doubles, junior tourneys, senior tourneys, and the wheelchair tourneys. It is held in Queens, New York. The next we have is French Open. This interesting tournament is played on clay courts. It's played on clay courts. French Open is held in Paris, France every year from late May to early June. Its initial women's tournament was held in year 1897. Now let's come to the fourth one. It is held in January each year in Melbourne Park, Australia, and its name is Australian Open. Australian Open was first played in 1905 in Melbourne, and since then it has become the first major slam of each year. So this is all about your chapter number 20, Grand Slam. Now let's come to the next chapter, that is 21. So this is your chapter number 21, Sport Thrills. Now we have to read the following instructions and match them with the photographs related pictures. Now the first one is using an inflatable raft to navigate a river or other body of water. So the correct answer is rafting. Very good. Come to the second one. Riding across or down a sand dune while standing on a board without bindings. And the correct answer is sandboarding. Very nice. Come to the third one. Traveling in canyons using a variety of techniques. And the answer is canyoning. Very good. The fourth one is using a canoe to paddle down a river with many rapids. And the correct answer is canoeing. Very nice. Come to the fifth one. Long vigorous walk, usually on trails in the countryside. And the answer is hiking. Very good. Next, sixth one. Moving over snow. Moving over snow by using a pair of long flat runners called skis attached to shoes or boots. So the correct answer is skiing. Yes, skiing. Now come to the next. So the next is worksheet number 2. So yes class, Now you have to fill in the blanks with the correct answers. Okay. So the first one is, who is the founder of eBay? Yes, Pierre Omidyar. Pierre Omidyar. The second one is, tell me, who has a head? Who has a head full of poisonous snakes? Yes, Medusa. Medusa has a head full of poisonous snakes. Come to the third one. Ariel was a? Yes, Ariel was a mermaid. Ariel was a mermaid. Come to the fourth one. Who won the first T20 World Cup in 2007? Yes, India. India won the first T20 World Cup in 2007. Very good. Come to the fifth one. Which country invented the T20 cricket format? Yes, very good. England. England invented the T20 cricket format. The next is the French Open. The French Open is held in Paris. Correct answer. Very good. Next, who is one of the major characters of To Kill a Mockingbird? Yes, tell me the answer. It is Atticus Finch. Yes, the answer is Atticus Finch. Very good. Atticus Finch is one of the major characters of To Kill a Mockingbird. Now let's come to the eighth one. A dash symbolizes good luck. So who symbolizes good luck? Unicorn. Very good. A unicorn symbolizes good luck. Next, dash involves long walks, usually on trails. Yes, hiking. Very nice. Hiking involves long walks, usually on trails. Now come to the 10th one. The character Pip is in the novel Great Expectations. Very good. The character Pip is in the novel Great Expectations. So this is all about the worksheet number 2. Now let's come to the next chapter. The chapter number is 22. So the chapter name is Flags and Nations. Now in this chapter, identify the national flags of some countries given below. Take help from the help box and write their names. Now let's discuss the first row. In the first row, the first flag of USA. Very good. And the second one, Italy. Then the next, Russia. And the next, France. Very nice. Come to the second row. Yes, the first one of the second row is Finland. The next, Greece. And this one, Brazil. Very nice. And this one, Sri Lanka. Now let's come to the third row. The first flag of the third row belongs to Afghanistan. Very good. After that, Argentina. Yes. And this one, Canada. Very good. And the last but not the least, Egypt. Yes. So this is all about this chapter 22, Flags and Nations. Now let's move on to the next chapter. Next chapter, number 23, Famous Explorers. Now we will be reading some points about the famous explorers. In the late 15th century and early 16th century, Europe sent out explorers in search of new lands or trade routes around the world. Now let's read about these explorers. Number one is a Portuguese navigator and explorer, Ferdinand Magellan, was the first European to discover the Pacific Ocean and the Strait of Magellan in 1519. 1919, he and his crew were also the first ones to travel around the world, proving that the earth is round. The second we have is Christopher Columbus. Christopher Columbus was a navigator and an admiral whose four voyages opened the way of European exploration and exploitation. He discovered viable sailing routes to America. Hence, he is known as the discoverer of the New World. The next explorer is a Portuguese navigator and explorer. Vasco da Gama was the first person to sail directly from Europe to India. His initial voyage to India was the first link to connect Europe and Asia. His discoveries made Portugal as one of the most important sea trading nations. Yes. Now let's come to the next one. A Venetian merchant, Marco Polo, traveled from Europe to Asia from 1271 to 95. His book, The Travels of Marco Polo, is one of the greatest travelogues of the time. He spent 17 years in China and became friends with Kublai Khan. The next is Amerigo Vespucci, was an Italian merchant and cartographer who recognized North and South America as two different continents. He made this discovery while sailing through the tip of South America in 1501. Prior to his discovery, Americans were thought to be part of Asia, as Columbus and others assumed. The next explorer is Ibn Battuta. Ibn Battuta was a Muslim explorer who traveled through many countries from North Africa to China in 29 years. His experiences are collected in a book called Ibn Battuta's Rihla or Journey. The last but not the least, James Cook was a British naval captain and navigator who mapped Newfoundland, East Canada, that is. He led three voyages to the Pacific Ocean and discovered Australia. He has traveled extensively to all seven continents, crossing all oceans and both the poles. Now, let's read this fact. Did you know? Marco Polo's book greatly described the Silk Road in China. It was printed in French, Italian, and Latin. Now, on the basis of our discussion, let's do this question. Question is, take the correct answer. Number first is, in which year did Vasco da Gama die? Yes, and the correct option is 1524. The second one is, in which country was Marco Polo captured after his return from China? Yes, and the country name is Venice. Very good. The third question, how many journeys did Christopher Columbus make to the New World? Yes, class, how many journeys? Four journeys, very good. Fourth one, after whose name was the Pacific Ocean named Mar Pacificio? Yes, and the correct option is Ferdinand Magellan. So, class, this is all about your GK chapters from 20 to 23 along with your worksheet number 2. Thank you, have a nice day and take care.